folks, I'm Ian Baker, the product specialist with Camping World, and today we're going to go over the 2018 Volante 310BH. If you're looking for a somewhat shorter fifth wheel that has quad bunks, then this is certainly one you want to pay attention to. We'll actually start off right over here on the kitchen. So something that I really like that they have done is they put solid surface countertops in here, and they are absolutely gorgeous. And you'll see this provides excellent usable prep space. Far too often in this floor plan, you don't have this prep space over here or in the front, but what they did is they recessed the sink back a little, so that way you can still access a sink very easily here, but then when you move over, you have all the prep space. So I think they did a good job in designing the countertop itself. Obviously, as you can see, you have the sink top covers. When we remove those, that reveals your undermount double stainless steel bowl sink. You also have the high-rise faucet here, so that way if you are washing or rinsing any pots or pans, it's a little bit easier to be able to wash those. Now, if we take a look down underneath, we'll actually start right here by your front entrance. A couple things. One, before I open this, you can actually see the blue light they have here. They have accent lighting all the way throughout underneath the countertop, which is cool. But when you open that up, you see you have good storage right there as well. And I like that because as soon as you come in, if you want, you can use that as shoe storage. At least that's what I would do. That way your shoes are out of the way and not just clogging up your entryway. If you need to, though, you can always use that for pots and pans, of course, too, because it is such a large storage space. Then we come back around to the front, you'll see you have three drawers here. The top two are the same size. The bottom one here is a little bit deeper. So if you have some larger items like an apple corer or maybe like a power wine opener, something like that, those items will fit in that larger bin. Then as you sneak around right over here, you'll notice you do have a cubby hole up top. So if you want to put some spices in there, you can do that. Then down below, you have some great storage there. So, you know, again, I would probably put my pots and pans in there, but you know, when you own it, you can obviously put things away however you want. When we take a look up top here, a couple things. You notice you have two doors here. Open that up. The shelf is already built in, which I think is good. Without it, you kind of have big open wasted space. You'd have to do some kind of organizational system in there, but I think they did a good job with putting these in. One other thing I do want to mention is this right over here, folks. So this one does have a fireplace, but it has a 30-amp power connection. So what you want to do is if you want to use the fireplace, you have to switch it to fireplace. Otherwise, you have it in the down position for the microwave. So you do have to choose between the two as far as which one you want to use. If you drop down underneath, you will see you have an LED light here and then an electrical outlet. You know, any good kitchen has to have one. That way you can plug in your coffee maker, blender, electric griddle, whatever else you need to plug in there. Right up the top is your microwave, as we just talked about a second ago. So if you want to use it, there it is. Down below that is your hood with a light and fan. Cool decorative backsplash here. You know, it kind of has like a, not quite a marble look to it, but I don't know. It just kind of like a natural rock look to it almost. So I think that's really nice. You can see they framed it out as well. Right here in the back, you have slots. If you want to stick some knives down there, you can do that. Then you have the three burner cooktop here, the front one being high output. And underneath you have an oven in case you want to do some baking. Right beneath that, you have your propane detector right here to make sure you don't have any leaks. And then this panel pops open just like so. This will have your fuses for your 110 power as well as, your breakers for 110, fuses for your 12 volt. As you move over a little further here, finishing out the kitchen, you have some storage right up top there. You have the 7 cubic foot fridge freezer. We open that up, you'll see one of the things I like about this is right back here, your fins have the plastic covering over them to make sure that you don't damage your fins or, you know, damage any items you put in there. If you put in like a carton of milk or something, it's not going to cut into it. This unit does run off both propane and electric and also has automatic switchover. Thermostat right back here. This unit does have ducted AC as well as ducted heat. You'll also see right down below there, you have an electrical outlet. So we'll hit the bathroom and the bunk room in just a moment, but first let's finish out our living area here, and that is on our living area slide. So this is a super slide, meaning it has both the dinette and the sofa. Large U-shaped dinette, which is great because that way, you know, when everyone's sitting down, gives you more elbow room. You know, in a normal dinette, the other person's sitting right here, you're elbowing them as you're eating. With the U-shaped, you'll have two people here, another person there, and so that way you have more elbow room while you're eating. U-shaped dinettes generally don't seat more people than a standard dinette. You can usually only fit about four before you start hitting knees. But again, the advantage is you get elbow room and these make a much larger bed. because you can drop this table down. You just remove the legs. It'll sit on the inside of the rails here, and you'll be able to sleep two adults here on this U-dinette. The light up top is LED. That's important to know if you plan on doing some boondocking, because a lot of times this is an incandescent light, but not the case here. You'll also see you have a big window right there to let in a lot of natural light. And then over to this side, you have a couple windows here, including one on the side of the slide, again, to let that light in. Storage up top with the frosted glass. If we open that up, you can see the storage right in there. And then underneath is the trifold sofa. So the cool thing about a trifold is, again, not only is it comfortable to sit on, but folks, this also folds out into another very comfortable bed. You can easily sleep two adults here as well, and you won't have a bar on your back or have an air mattress that's going to deflate on you. One last thing I did want to touch on here on the dinette is your storage. If you take a look right here, you do have these pull-out trays on both sides. So this is pretty easy access to that storage underneath the dinette. You don't have to lift up the seat cushions or anything. You can just pull that right out. Lastly, we get to the entertainment center. You'll see where your TV goes right here in the center. They did mark where they put a mounting bracket, so you know exactly where to mount the TV. The corresponding connections are right over here, including your audio video cables, which are connected to the multimedia center. Because not only is this a radio that controls your speakers inside and outside, it is also a DVD player. So if you want to watch a movie, you can pop it right in there. And if you do just want to listen to music, that unit is Bluetooth capable. Main control panel is right next to that. You'll see your tank monitoring panel, as well as your slide controls, awning control. All your lights and everything will be right there too. If we take a look up top here, good storage going along the top. Same thing along the side. Now, it's not super deep storage, folks, but it is storage nonetheless. So, you know, hopefully you can find some items to fit in there. And then you have storage here too. Lastly, right down below is the other item I talked about. We're talking about that switch, and that is the fireplace. So if you've never owned a fireplace in an RV before, a lot of people just think that, you know, maybe it's overkill or whatever it may be. But folks, it's not just for aesthetics. While yes, it does look very nice, more importantly, that is a space heater. So if you're at a campground where you have shore power and you don't want to use your propane, you know, maybe it's not getting too cold, but it's just a little chilly, you can turn that on and it'll help take the chill off in this main living space. As we make our way back, you will see straight across from the bathroom here, you have a large storage area. Now you can use this for multiple things. If you have an overflow of the kids' clothes, you can put that in here. If you need it for extra food items to the pantry, you can put that in here. Personally, myself, I would probably dedicate at least some of it for a linen closet, that we have a spot to put all your towels. But again, as I mentioned previously, you can do as you wish. When you make your way into the bathroom itself, you will notice there's a second door here, which I certainly enjoy. That way, you know, if the kids or yourself need to come in and use the bathroom, you can come in, do the business, and head right back out without traipsing dirt throughout the entire RV. Over to the side here is the tub shower. You will see that you have good shelf space there, a hand wand, and because it's a fifth wheel, you have plenty of headroom even without the skylight. The skylight does still add a lot of natural light in here. You have a mirrored medicine cabinet right here up front, storage behind that. Drop down below, you'll notice your sink here with your countertop. And then right over here to the right underneath, rather, you have additional storage there. And lastly, folks, right here is your foot flush lever toilet. This one is a porcelain bowl, which makes it much easier to clean. As we step back into the bunk room, one of the things you will notice is that you actually do have a sliding, almost farm style door on here. I personally like that. That way, if you do have people over, you're staying up a little bit later than the kids, you can close the door, give them a little bit of privacy. That way they can go to sleep at night. If we take a look over at the slide out side of the bunk room here, the top bunk does fold up and lock in place just like so. 300 pound weight capacity on here. You can see it is a fairly deep bunk, which is great. Right underneath that, you have your jackknife sofa here. So this gives us a spot for the kids to be able to sit down and they can watch TV here if they want. I can show you where that is in just a minute. This also folds down into a bed. And lastly, right down here, you have this almost trundle style bed right here. And this this pad right here obviously pulls out with it, teddy bear bunk series. But this will actually make up your third bunk. So you pull that right on out, giving three beds on this side. The fourth one, the reason it's a quad bunk, of course, is this one right up here. 300 pound weight capacity on this one as well. You do have a window there for natural light, LED lights throughout. You also have a ladder right up here, so that way the person can climb up quite easily. I really like this because most of the time it's the smaller kids that want to sleep in the top bunk, and they're usually ones that have a hard time getting up here. So this makes life a little easier. Now you'll notice you do have a shelf back here as well as a bunch of storage behind the ladder. Personally, I'd probably store like my vacuum cleaner back there, but again, you know, as I mentioned before, you can do as you want. And then right down here, you can see you have a good storage, probably a good spot for like a DVD collection. This right here naturally is for the TV. The connections are right up top here. You have a couple of USB ports there as well. And lastly, over to this side, you have a couple of shelves. When we step up into the master bedroom, you'll see your queen bed right here in the center. This does have storage underneath, and as you'll see, it is strut supported, so it's easy to raise up as well as lower back down. On both sides of the bed, you have some storage. You see you have hanging rods there, so you have a wardrobe on either side. On the one side here down beneath, you have dual USB ports. On the other side, you will have your normal 110 outlet. So based upon what you're plugging in, you know, whether you're plugging in a phone or maybe if you need to plug in a CPAP machine, you'll want to put that on this side over here. You also have additional storage going across the top. Underneath, you have a couple reading lights as well as that blue accent LED light there. And the headboard itself kind of tries to take on a shiplap look. You'll have windows on either side to let in some natural light as well as cross ventilation. You have a vent right here. So again, if you don't want to run that ducted AC, you can open up the windows, open this up, and be able to get that airflow through. If we take a look at the foot of the bed, you have a sliding door right here, just like we did in the bunk room. A dresser with a good size countertop here, which is cool because this is where your TV will sit. You want to set it right here. You'll see the connections for that there. And then you obviously have drawers underneath. That way it is a good workable dresser. Two on the one side, three on the other. Over here, you actually have a third and very large wardrobe. So if you plan on spending some time in here, you want to hang up a lot of clothes, you can certainly do that. Or maybe, you know, because it's, you know, you don't have a great spot to hang up jackets. If you'd like to do a lot of cold weather camping, you can use this as a coat closet too. And then right underneath, you see you have two additional drawers there. Now that we've seen the inside, let's take a quick look at some of the outside features on the Volante 310BH. Starting off right up front here, you have a good looking front cap on there, a couple LED lights inlaid in there as well to give it that extra pop and aesthetic at night. You'll also see this one does come with the 3-year structural warranty. That is the current leading warranty in the industry. If we take a look down below here, you'll notice this front compartment is very clean, folks. They do a good job of making sure you don't have anything running through here as far as electrical, plumbing, or anything like that, so that this is good usable space. Off to the side there, you will notice your battery box. And right outside, you have a light there as well as your solar prep. So if you do want solar, all you have to do is buy the portable panels, plug them in right there, and it will trickle charge your battery. Let's take a look at the side right here. So you will see the large power awning. Touch a button to roll that out, same thing to have it go right back in. Then you have an LED light strip underneath so you have light at night. Couple outside speakers there. Those are controlled by that multimedia center inside, but that unit is Bluetooth capable. So if you want to sit out here underneath your awning, you know, just chilling in your chair, you can control that music from here. As we come to the side here, we'll open up this front door and you see that this shares the same compartment as the front storage area. You will see in the back there, you have a small door on the off door side. That is basically the same as this, only obviously on the other side here, but that is access to this top storage. All of it is basically one big shared space, but it allows you to navigate through there easily without having to put your whole body into the pass through there. If we take a look at the entryway, you will see you have three foldable steps as well as a foldable grab handle right here. So that way you have good control when entering or exiting the RV. Making our way back a little further, right here is your fresh tank fill. If you plan to do some boondocking, that is where you'll want to fill your fresh tank. You have a cable outlet as well as an electrical outlet. So if you want TV outside, those will be the connections for that. Beautiful aluminum alloy rims there, folks. Not only do they look great now, they will continue to do so for years to come. And then right here is the secondary entrance, as I showed you inside. This one leads into the bathroom. Right back here is the outside kitchen. This, of course, is one of my favorite parts of having a bunk model. You get the nice big fridge out here, so you have plenty of space for condiments or beverages. Storage up top there. I'll open that up so you can take a look. You have a light over here in case you need to get in here at night. TV hookups again. So if you want a TV back here, you have plenty of countertop space in which you can set the TV. sink right there in the center. Over here, you have a drop-down compartment. You'll see that's good extra storage, maybe a decent place, to put some like paper plates or something in there. And then right here is your pull-out cooktop. So we'll pull this out, open it up for you. You can see the two-burner cooktop right there. This one, of course, does run off propane, and that corresponding connection will be right down below. You can see it right here. That's your propane quick connect. If you don't want to use a cooktop, you can always use your grill. Just remember, if your grill has a regulator on it, you want to take that off because your pressure is regulated at your tanks. You have your rear-mounted ladder here, so you can climb up onto the roof for any kind of maintenance or just get up there for a higher vantage point. Right in the center is your backup camera prep. So if you want a backup camera, this makes it easier to have it installed, meaning it will save you money on labor. You have your square tubular bumper with end caps that will house your sewer hose. And then right on the back here is the spare tire. Great thing about having it on the back, folks, is this is probably the easiest place to access it. You don't have to get down your hands and knees or crawl underneath your fifth wheel to get to it. And then right over here, you have your cable and satellite inlets. Right here in between the two off-door slides, you will notice you have your 30-amp power cord right here, black tank flush to wash out any solids that are left in your black tank after you dump it. Your city water inlet is on this side, and then you also have the outside shower with both hot and cold water access. Right over here is the storage we saw while we were on the camp side. And then right here, folks, are your two 30-pound propane tanks. All right, folks, that wraps it up. Again, this is the 2018 Volante 310BH. If you're interested in this fifth wheel and you'd like price and availability, simply click on the link in the description below. Thanks again for watching. I'm Ian Baker, and let's go camping.